In the prefatory materials of an ETDR document, the table of contents, the list of figures, and the list of tables are fairly common. In some cases, an electronic thesis, dissertation, or report may not have figures, or they may not have tables, which means that those respective lists should not appear. To remove these, merely highlight the placeholder lists of figures, lists of tables, and delete. Do not delete page or section breaks, though. Okay, in other cases, the graduate student may need a list of equations. So there's a navigable way to get to these respective equations. In other cases, the graduate student may need a list of nomenclature or a list of terminology to make their work more readable. To make a navigable list of equations, it is important to first caption the equations. So for our example, we'll just go somewhere in the text. I'm gonna just insert an equation here. So I'm going to put the cursor in a left justified way and go up to the Insert tab. I'm gonna go to Equation. I'm gonna use a pre-built area of a circle, and we have an equation. The way it works in Word is we'll put a cursor above the equation. We're going to go to the References tab in the ribbon. We're going to go to Insert Caption. For the label, we're going to make that equation. For the numbering, I'm going to ask the auto equation captioner to put in the chapter number based on the heading 1 style. I will use a period as the separator. I'm going to click OK. And this all looks good. This is a window that I should never touch and never edit. This is auto-generated up here. I'm going to click OK. And now it says equation 1.1. And I'm going to put type of period. I'm going to put area of a circle. And I'm going to remove the boldface. So now I have a caption. So when I click on here, you can see in the body text, in the styles pane, it says caption. And it's right above the equation. So notice I gave it a name, so that when we make the list of equations, it will know what we're talking about. And so I'm going to go back up to the list of tables. Now I'm going to make the actual list of equations. And a quick and dirty way to do this is just to highlight and copy. So I'm going to go ahead and highlight the title here. So I'm going to put it below the page break. Go like this, and I'm gonna hold down Control Enter to add another page break. So I'm gonna call this list of equations, and then here to make the actual table below, I'm gonna go to Insert. I'm gonna go to the References tab in the ribbon. Insert table of figures in the captions area, and it's smart enough to know that I'm trying to do something with the equations. These presets are correct. I'm going to hit OK, and it automatically puts in equation 1.1 period, area of a circle, and then there's the auto pagination. And if I hold down Control and I click here, it will take me right to the equation. So that's generally how you would put in a list of equations. Now, some people like how LaTeX looks, so they would want an equation on the left maybe, and then they're gonna want auto numbering on the right. The basic way that can be done in Word is to insert a table with two cells, on one side, you can insert in equation, and we'll use the same one again. And then on the right side, you can go ahead and make an open parenthesis, a closed parenthesis, and then put in auto numbering here. And when you, it would also be the chapter and then the number. So this would be chapter one, equation one. 1.2 would be chapter one, equation two, and so on. And what you do is you highlight the table. And what most people do is they make it so that there are no borders. So you can come here and just turn off the borders, the vertical lines, and the vertical lines down here, and then the horizontal lines here. I think, I don't know if that one works. Yeah. So these dotted lines then are viewable to you because you're in edit mode. But when you output them into PDF, they will not show up, right? So anyway, so people have different ways of representing equations. And then I'm going to go ahead and jump back up to the list of equations. Now, if people want to have a list of nomenclature or a list of terminology, oftentimes they, again, we just will just highlight the title here, which is a page heading TOC style. And we're going to go ahead and hold down Control Enter to make a page break in Word for Windows, paste. So we can say list of nomenclature or list of, I'll just say terminology here. And sometimes people will just have two columns. They will have an alphabetized list of the terminology and then the definitions to the right. Generally, a lot of people will not make the list of terminology navigable because they're going to use the terms throughout their ETDR. But that basically shows you how to put in a list of equations and a list of terminology if those are needed.